This would be a lot more of a win for everyone involved if I looked like Father Mike Schmitz. One of our earliest saints in church history, known as Saint Athanasius, had this great line where he said, "God became man so that man could become God." And at first hearing it, it might kind of strike you as a funny phrase or a funny thing to say. God became man so that man could become God. But like, how's that possible, right? There's only one God. There's only one God that's existence himself, that's this being itself. How's that possible? It's not possible, right? But I think a key to think about or understanding this is the fact that also in the story of the prodigal son, the father says to the son that stayed, the one who's always there, "All that I have is yours." We have a God who so abundantly and ridiculously wants to pour out his entire self into us. He wants to share all that he is. And so in that capacity, we actually can take on God's own very nature in a way. We can take in his love, to take in his grace, his truth, his beauty, his goodness, and become so like him. And this is a key aspect of discipleship. God wants us so fundamentally close to him that we reveal him and look like him and become one with him. And that's kind of this drastic setting that God has set up for us. In our previous episode, we talked about this idea of discipleship. And discipleship, I mean, kind of made some distinctions between terminology and what discipleship is, but we decided we wanted to focus in on intentional discipleship, which was the purposeful endeavor to come to a relationship with Christ, to come into contact, into communion with him, so as to share him with others. We talked about this idea of the funnel, right? So a funnel is what we are to become as disciples. A funnel is open large at one end so as to receive, to get, so for the sake of giving, not just to have it for itself, but to give it away. This is the spiritual dynamics. And this also ties closely to God. God just is love itself, which love desires to give itself away. It's diffusive of itself is the technical term for that, right? God wants to give himself away. And so we're supposed to, in kind, become like him, receive so we can give ourselves away. You know, there's one scripture in particular where Jesus kind of talks about this. He's talking to his disciples and he goes, and this is in John chapter 15, verse 15, he says, "No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends." It's a great line. It's a beautiful line. And in fact, this is the type of nature that God is trying to invite us into his own divine life, into himself. Today, I really just want to talk about really two kind of habits, and we'll talk about two more in the next episode. But today, I really want to speak about going to the sacraments and then prayer and reading scripture, and those as fundamental habits to being disciples. So first, let's talk about the sacraments a little bit, right? We are very blessed that God actually instituted a church because he wanted to be present to us throughout all of history. And he does this through his church, right? We receive these sacraments that he pours out to us and he gives us regularly so we can get his grace, so we can become more and more like him. The two I want to specifically speak about today are the ones that we can most readily go to, right? So the sacrament of reconciliation or confession and the sacrament of the Eucharist. Now, the Eucharist is the very sustenance we need to live this life. I would never even imagine trying to go ahead and run a marathon, but I would never imagine trying to run a marathon after starving myself for, let's say, 3 weeks. Imagine not eating for 3 weeks and then saying, yeah, I'm going to go out and run a marathon. It just couldn't happen. You wouldn't be able to do it. You'd probably collapse and, you know, whatever. Your blood sugar would be all crazy. It just physically would be impossible to do. Same thing. That's in the physical realm. You might think to yourself, oh, I'm going to try to lose some weight and try to be as light as possible so I can run the marathon. But that thinking would be flawed, obviously, because you just don't have the energy. You don't have the fuel necessary to complete the project. Same with our spiritual lives. I can never imagine living this life, being the husband, being the brother, the son, being the minister that I'm called to be, without spiritually having sustenance, without spiritually having the food that God knows I need to live this life, to forgive my enemies, to just do the very hard things it means to follow Christ. We cannot do it on our own. We need spiritual sustenance, and that is found in the Eucharist. There's obviously a lot of reasons to go to Mass. One is just worshiping God. He deserves our worship. He doesn't need it. He's God whether we worship it or not. But we go because he deserves our worship and we want to. It actually changes us in a positive way. That's a whole nother episode, whole nother video we can make. But we go to Mass specifically because we know we need the Eucharist. It doesn't matter if the homily is great, if the music's not so good, or if, you know, the lighting's horrible in the church and just bad architecture. It doesn't, any of those things, sure, they help us in our worship, but at the end of the day, none of it matters as much as actually receiving the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus Christ, because I need it to sustain the spiritual life that he has called me to live. Same thing with reconciliation. Let's look at it from a physical standpoint. I would never go that long without showering. Why? Because I like friends. You know, it's nice to have people to talk to and converse with. And in a similar vein, you know, if you go that long without showering, people are just going to, you're going to be repellent to people. People don't want to be near you. In a similar vein, spiritually speaking, I need a shower every so often. Probably about once a month, every 6 weeks or so, I try to go myself to the Sacrament of Reconciliation. Why? Because I know that my soul needs that healing. I know my soul needs that cleaning so that I can have the relationship with God that I know I need to have. I don't know about you, but I regularly sin. I regularly mess up, and this kind of fractures and distorts my relationship with God, and I want to restore it. I want to make it whole and clean and better again, and so I go to the Sacrament of Reconciliation so as to keep that relationship on point. Remember, as intentional disciples, the point is, first and foremost, to have this personal, real relationship with God so that we can share it with others. Not just to follow theoretical teachings, but to actually follow and know him. We come into contact with him every time we go to the sacraments. So that's kind of the first move that we should make as disciples, is just run to the sacraments. Secondarily, prayer and reading of scripture. Now, I think a lot of us probably have pretty decent prayer lives, or I hope that we do anyway. You know, we could spend some time, some people like to do prayer in the morning, some people like to do it at the end of the day, some people do both. Whatever habits you have formed, it's important just to have some sort of discipline and habit of prayer. Why? Because again, if you're in a relationship, you spend time talking with and being with that one with whom you're in relationship. It'd be weird if I married my wife and just never talked to her, ever. Like, that'd be strange. And the same thing with Christ. If I'm in a relationship, if I want to be his disciple, I have to spend the time with him. We do this through prayer, and most specifically, we can do it through reading scripture tied to our prayer. I talk to a lot of people, and they say, you know, hey, I pray, but I don't really feel like I'm hearing God. You know, they might pray rosaries, or they kind of do their Our Fathers and Hail Marys, which are all great, by the way. But they don't necessarily spend the time in contemplation and creating the space to really hear God's voice. We'll develop that a little bit more in the next session when we're going to talk about discerning God's will and when we talk about docility to the Spirit. But for today's purposes, reading scripture is just a simple way that we can actually hear more God's voice more loudly in our lives. You know, we tend to overcomplicate it too. I think just pick it up and read. That really helps. God's word is living and true. And if you don't know where to begin, I'd say begin in the Gospels. It's very simple to read. And if you take the challenge to read a chapter a day and just work your way through Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, work your way through all four Gospels, you're going to notice a difference in yourself and how you hear God, how you understand God, how you see his moves in your life. And really, the prayer is that when we read scripture, we're not reading it as much as we're allowing it to read us. When you kind of put yourself in a prayerful mode and into that kind of space where you want the scripture to wash over you, to read you more than you reading it as like some sort of study, well, now you're kind of putting yourself in a space to be conformed and changed by it. That's not to take anything away from Bible studies. Again, it's kind of taking the time to study, to figure out who God is. What does he ask us to do? That's all beautiful stuff. So I encourage you, sign up for a Bible study, or you can find some online if there's not one happening at the parish that you want to participate in. There's also podcasts out there. There's books you can read. And we'll have all sorts of resources available to you within this study as well, within this discipleship series. But all of this is to say that if we want to be disciples, if we really want to come into that unique relationship, that real relationship with Christ, we have to spend the time going to the sacraments. We have to spend the time in the basic moves of prayer and reading scripture. This is how we come into contact with him, and it's going to change how we pour our lives out and pour out this same prayer, pour out the sacraments we receive so that we can give. I hope this has been helpful for you guys today. And like I said, next session, we'll be talking a little bit more about docility to the Spirit and how we actually discern God's will in our lives. And these are also helpful moves and the habits we form around those so that we can regularly be working and having the Spirit work through us. Thanks, guys.